Houdini 19 is here. Let's check out this new node together.
Vellum Fluids, this node is awesome. We finally have a really simple method of getting great interaction between fluid and other Vellum objects. Obviously, Vellum is not meant to replace flip fluids, and there are many things that this node is not meant to do, but it's really simple to set up and use. So let's take a look at a simple setup and then look at some of the settings. So let's start in an empty scene. We'll create a geo container and dive inside. In Houdini 19, we now have the option to create spheres as polygons or polygon mesh, which is awesome and saves some clicking. Let's now move our sphere a little bit higher so that it's not on the floor. We'll then reduce the scale to something like 0.1. Now let's drop down a Vellum fluid. We don't see anything because our sphere is small and the particle size is too big. So let's drop this down to something like 0.004. For now, we'll leave the rest as is. Now, if we want a single emission, we can drop down a Vellum solver, add a ground plane and hit play. Beautiful. The problem is that we want this to be a constant emission, like we're turning on the kitchen tap. Now in the SOP level Vellum solver, the option to enable this is not promoted for us to adjust it. So we have to dive inside the Vellum solver to change it. But in these situations, I find it a lot easier just to create my own .NET quickly. So let's create a .NET. We'll dive inside. We need a Vellum solver, Vellum object, and Vellum source. Let's also add a gravity and a ground plane. Make sure that your ground plane is on the left side of the merge. We're going to use a small expression to get the first input of our .NET. Now if we hit play, we have the same thing that we had with our SOP level Vellum solver. Let's jump onto our Vellum source and change only once to each sub-step. If you want to limit how long it'll be emitted for, you can keyframe or use an expression in the activation field. For our use, we'll just leave it emitting forever. This looks amazing, but to get some more useful movement, let's do some simple animations on the SOP level. First, let's subdivide our sphere. Then we'll use an attribute noise set to 0 centered and a really low amplitude. Let's turn on animation. This just breaks up our source and gives better simulation results. Then let's drop down a transform and rotate using this expression. This expression just uses the frame value and I'm multiplying it by 6 so that it rotates faster. Lastly, let's offset our original sphere on the x-axis. So now we get a sphere that is noised up and rotating. Now, if we look at the Vellum fluid node, you'll notice a physical attributes dropdown. If we take a look, we have some options. The main two are viscosity and surface tension. Let's take a look at the different results we can get in our setup when we change these. Viscosity makes your fluid thick and sticky due to the internal friction. Surface tension causes the fluid to attract to itself, creating these really cool blobs and tendrils. I often find myself dialing in a little bit of both viscosity and surface tension to get some nice stable results. Vellum fluid also allows viscosity and surface tension by attributes, so you can have various attributes throughout your points. In this example, I have a noised up sphere that I moved just above the floor. Now after my Vellum fluid, I dropped an attribute noise and I set its attribute type to float and I named it viscosity. I set the values to whatever I wanted. In this case, I used a value of 160,000. Something else the Vellum fluid node has is this phase value. This is an identifier for the Vellum solver that we are feeding in multiple fluid simulations. So it'll treat each fluid separately rather than together. This is obviously really useful. Let's take a look at how we can set up a more complicated example using multiple fluids as well as mixing in some other Vellum constraints. In this scene, I have three objects. I have two fluid objects, and I have a pig head, which I've turned into a tetrahedral soft body. Let's take a look at how I've set these up. I started with a box. I transformed this box to be somewhere else in space. And then I turned it into a Vellum fluid. You'll notice that I have this set to phase one, a viscosity of 500 and the surface tension of 20. I've then just given this a color of white. My second fluid is these blue boxes that you can see up here. I've given these a really high viscosity, and I've also set this phase to 2. I've matched the particle separation or the particle size to be the same as my first fluid. For my pig head, I've subdivided my pig head. I've then remeshed it to give it some uniform triangles. I find Vellum works a lot better when you feed it uniform triangles. I've then transformed it to be in the place that I want it to be. And then I've used the Vellum configure tetrahedral soft body, and I've left all the values at default. I've then taken all the geometry streams and merged them, and all the constraint streams, and I've merged those. For my collider, I've created a box. I've then used the delete node using the bounding box to delete the top. I poly extrude it to give it some thickness. I find Vellum really appreciates having thickness, and it solves a lot easier. I then just use a poly bevel to give it some nice rounding. Now we plug this all into our Vellum solver. You'll notice that I've given it 10 sub-steps and 10 constraint iterations. In my forces tab, I've just removed all the friction. Now when we solve this, this is what we get. Post-sim, I'm using the same phase attribute to split my geometry. So I'm using at phase equals 1 and 2. So this is basically removing my two fluid sources and just giving me my pig head. I can then convert the tetrahedral soft body back into polygons, subdivide it, and then use a normal point deform to point deform my original high geometry mesh onto my low geometry mesh. I can then merge these streams together and get really nice mutual interaction between vellum constraints. Something else that is definitely worth pointing out is that within the new Vellum SOP solver, you can now add multiple sources inside. This is really useful when you combine multiple constraints and you want Vellum fluid to be a constant emission. You can dive inside and source your Vellum fluid and do the usual emission tricks. The rest works as normal and you get some great interactions. Check out the free HIP files that I've attached to this project, as I've included a couple other examples which may be useful for your project. But now it's time for you to dive into Houdini and make something cool. It's Houdini time.